Hello students, I welcome you all to this virtual learning online platform. Presently we are dealing with T.S. Pillai's from Pakistan, a famous short story based on the theme of partition. So far we discussed that Kishan Kumar and Abdullah, both of them have been the very good friends. They had no difference of opinion at all. But the thought of a separate nation has entirely taken the toll of Abdullah's mind. And I think that was the influence of the person called Mudal Ali, who was organizing the people of the place, encouraging them to pack up and get ready to move towards the territory of Pakistan. Their constant slogans for Pakistan, it was really disturbing. Kishan Kumar, because Kishan Kumar being a Hindu, of course loved his country and he was very happy that they were getting freedom from the British Raj. The illusionary dreams shown by the scene of partition in the story has deeply haunted the innocent mind of Abdul. And here Abdullah is a symbol. Abdullah is a representative of Muslim community. And according to his perception, the newly created Pakistan is going to be an ideal place for Muslims. And that will be the region of Allah. Actually, Abdullah was engrossed in attending the political processions and meetings which were organized by their leaders in the favor of the Muslim state of Pakistan. And since he was constantly attending the processions and meetings, his mind was totally occupied by the probable formation of a country called Pakistan. While doing so, he never felt that unknowingly or knowingly he was hurting his bosom friend Krishna Kumar. Because the creation of Pakistan for the Muslims, as it was a sentimental issue for the followers of Islam, On the other side, when you look at Krishna Kumar, who represents the Hindu community here in the story, also has a feeling that since I am a Hindu, India is meant for me. After the freedom, what did I get? I get freedom only, but at the cost of the division of my country. Some part of my region has to be allotted to the Muslims. Probably that kind of feeling was there in the mind of Krishna. And you see how the difference between the two was gradually increasing. When Abdullah started frequently visiting Mudal Ali and described the eloquence of his mansion to Krishna Kumar, Krishna Kumar, on the other hand, also started appreciating and admiring the zamindar of the place. Because the zamindar was a Hindu person. And of course, he was representing the Hindus over there. And gradually what happened? A kind of detachment, a kind of disturbance was created between them. Because of these communal feelings. In fact, before this particular scene that I am going to talk about, they never had any differences. They were the bosom friends, very close associates, and had a great mutual understanding between them. But now you see how the things are changing in the course of time. Once, when your Krishna Kumar and Abdullah were discussing these matters, Abdullah happened to scold Zamindar by addressing the Zamindar as a kafir. And immediately Krishna Kumar also retaliated. He also called Mudal Ali by naming him as an untouchable. So here, Kishan Kumar used to say, Hindustan Zindabad. On the other hand, Abdullah used to say, Pakistan Zindabad. So their sentimental attachment to their respective land has actually created a dispute between them. And that was gradually increasing. That was gradually increasing to such an extent that both of them started thinking on two different lines, as if East and West can never come together. Once Krishna Kumar complained to Abdullah why he was attending the processions in the favor of Pakistan, why he was attending the political meetings organized by the Muslims. The view behind this dialogue in the mind of Krishna Kumar was very clear that he did not want to lose his intimate friend. It was really painful for Krishna Kumar to imagine that Abdullah is going away from him. And the differences between the two, because of the feelings and emotions related to the religion, and of course, to the nation, that was really creating a big difference between the two. This is the ideological difference that I am talking about. Let's see. The mental condition of Krishna Kumar and the psychological stance of Krishna Kumar was not really admired, appreciated, and properly realized by Abdul. What happened then? The culmination of these ideological differences between the two led Abdullah slowly to forget his friend, and as he was preparing to leave for Karachi, one of the cities in the newly formed Pakistan. See here, right in the introduction itself, I told it was decided on 16th of June 1947 that Pakistan would appear as a Muslim country on the map of the world. And probably that was the biggest ever gain, that of the Muslims. But here, Krishna Kumar was thinking on a different line. He shouts that his friend is going to leave him forever. But on the contrary, you see, the shouting of Abdullah is also a very interesting factor of this story. He shouts that he is going to his haven. He is going to his own kingdom. He is going to the nation which is exclusively meant for the Muslims. A kind of geographical kingdom assigned for the Muslims. See the kind of scenario here. Whatever requests and humble pleas Krishna Kumar was doing, they were all rejected and denied by Abdullah. Krishna Kumar was literally bursting into tears. He was trying to convince Abdullah, but Abdullah was religiously motivated for the first time, and finally he decided that he is going to move towards Karachi in another few days. The idea of departure of his bosom friend psychologically made Krishna Kumar to psychologically collapse. One day, what happened? Abdullah immediately left for Karachi in the train to Pakistan. See the situation now. Krishna Kumar never liked that his friend should leave for Karachi. He wanted his friend's great company. But Abdullah was quite predetermined to leave for Karachi. Krishna Kumar consoled him a lot, convinced him a lot, but all his efforts were futile. And finally, Abdullah left for Karachi. See here, it is reported to us, and even if you turn the pages of the history, you will find the same. During that particular time, the people from both the countries experienced a massacre. There were so many communal riots in India and Pakistan both. The Muslims, those who were moving towards Pakistan, and the Hindus from the Pakistan territory moving towards India or the Hindustan, that really created a big chaos. And where these two friends, bosom friends, were lost, nobody knows. But here we are quite focused on the happenings in the life of these two. The story actually takes place in the backyard of a hotel, and nearby you have the mansions of the Zamindar and Mudal Ali also. The entire story has the, you know, background of the partition, processions and political meetings conducted by the Muslims, their restlessness and anxiety for the creation of their own country in the name of religion. This is all there that we know now. But once you start focusing on the life of Krishna Kumar and Abdullah, you will realize that Krishna Kumar really took it to his heart. He lived over there all alone. He missed the great company of his bosom friend Abdullah. And Krishna Kumar had infinite love and bond for Abdullah. But unfortunately, Abdullah never realized it till he left for Karachi. But you know, in the course of time, both of them have learned a lesson. Krishna Kumar learned the lesson of the loss of his friend, and he lived his life anyhow in isolation, still picking up the food from the garbage of the restaurant. On the other hand, you have Abdullah, who left for Karachi. But do you think that he was all happy over there after going to Karachi, the territory of Pakistan? No. One day, Abdullah was expected to come. Krishna Kumar was very, very optimistic that his friend Abdullah would come back. And again, both of them will have a great company over there. But what happened? The story continues with this background of the partition scenario. And immediately we are taken to the situation, to the scene after a few years. That is, after a few years, Krishna Kumar reached to the backside of the hotel where he used to pick up the food from the garbage of the hotel. He found his dear friend Abdullah's body lying in a sullen state just beside the garbage. As soon as Krishna Kumar looked at him, he became very emotional. But at the same time, he felt very bad that his friend Abdullah was very, very weak. He was even unable to get up. Krishna Kumar, with a great passion, with a great feeling of friendship, took his head on his lap and showered all his friendly affection that he had in his store for his friend, kissed Abdullah graciously, and constantly burst into tears. Actually, Abdullah was totally disillusioned. Whatever optimism that he had about the formation of Pakistan, about the exclusive country for Muslims. He was totally disillusioned and finally realized that he would get happiness only in the company of his friend whom he missed all these years. But I think it was too late for Abdullah to realize it and come back to Krishna Kumar. He was really fortunate enough that he could see Krishna Kumar towards the end of his life. Actually, Abdullah was on the verge of death. He had traveled all the way from Karachi. You know, see the culmination over here. He came back to this region of Hindustan to die into his friend's arms. Probably after going back to his own land called the land for the Muslims, whatever optimism he had before going to his land, probably in a very short period of time, that became the illusion. And in that frustration, he realized that he was running after an illusion. Finally, he got nothing. But when he is turning back, he lost his great bosom friend, Krishna Kumar. And this is the very sorrowful end of the life of Abdullah, right there in the arms of his friend, Krishna Kumar. See how effectively Pillai has presented all these scenes related to the partition of India. The partition has distracted the peaceful life of Krishna Kumar and Abdullah. They were very happy with the feeling that they were the friends only. But once the feeling of religion came in between, they got separate. Once the attachment for one's nation came in between, they got separated. And this was what happened in the life of these two. In the symbolical point of view, you can say that this is not just the case of Krishna Kumar and Abdullah. Probably it is the case of the millions of people living in India and Pakistan. If you turn the pages of the history, you will come to know that the partition has affected the lives of the millions of people in India and Pakistan. And all these experiences, those who had the first-hand experience of partition, probably they knew the real suffering. They knew the real, you know, traumas of partition. And all these things are very effectively presented by T.S. Pillai in this story. The plot of the story is very simple and straightforward. As I said right in the beginning, it defines the theme of partition and how adversely the division of India has affected the lives of innumerable people of the time. The plot dedicatedly exhibits that the separation of these two friends is symbolic. But however, there is a twist at the end of the story. When Abdullah comes back to India, only to die in the arms of his bosom friend, Krishna Kumar. But to the utter dismay for the readers, we find him dying in the hands of Krishna Kumar. He came back because he was disillusioned. And if you see today, after 70 to 74 years of independence, where do we stand as a country, that is India as a country? And where does Pakistan stand as a country? The strength and power and influence of India all over the world can be minutely noticed today. And the financial condition of the country like Pakistan, you can just compare and contrast. So here, with this happy note, that our country, India, will definitely have a bright future, I just put a full stop for this discussion and sign off from this platform. Jai Hind.